السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. Thank you very much for inviting me and giving me this honor to greet you on behalf of the Islamic Society of North America. Islamic Society of North America, as you may not know, is an umbrella organization representing many Islamic centers and organizations and communities throughout the US and Canada. It's one of the oldest Islamic organizations in this continent. And on behalf of all the members and the communities, I want to express my greetings for all of you. And also on behalf of the Islamic the Shura Council of Southern California. The Shura Council of Southern California is also a representative body of the Islamic Center of Southern California. There are about 60 Islamic centers in Southern California. Just a few years ago, I was thinking about that, and we had only about 2 or 3 Islamic centers. MashaAllah, centers have increased. In Orange County, we have only one center. That's like in Orange County, not more than 12 centers in Orange County. So there is an organization that brings all these centers together, and that is the Shura Council of Southern California, where we sit together, talk, and we communicate, consult with each other, and in many issues we work together, alhamdulillah. So on behalf of Shura Council, I express our greetings to all of you. I want to especially mention Dr. Yahya Abdurrahman, a pioneer of the Islamic world. He has a tremendous contribution for the Islamic world here in Southern California, a great fundraiser, mashallah, a great khatib, a great Islamic center, and a person who has really motivated and inspired many youth and old everyone. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless him and give him long life, a good health, a very happy alhamdulillah that he has recovered from his surgery, and we are very happy to see him, mashallah, in good health, and may Allah continually give him more and more health and give him long life. And blessings for him and his family, inshallah. His work at for the Dariba, American Transplant House, is also a very important work. And I'm very happy to see that this kind of programs are organized over here. And especially I want to greet Mr. Thomas Mullen and Mr. Paul Ahmed, both of them are the recipients of the award evening. Just a few words I want to say about you know that Islam has a very positive view for money. Most of the time you hear that religions have a negative view of money. Somehow religions and the world, consider that the world has to be avoided and the money has to be avoided. But Islam has a very positive view of money. Money is called in the Quran and Fadlullah. It is called Khair. The author mentioned that, I mean, something good. And it is also called Qiyam. Qiyam means the need of support. It's very interesting that the Quran two times word is used. One time the word is used Qiyam for money, and another time is used for Ka'ba. Ya'allahu Ka'ba, for the Ka'ba, Qiyamun Linnas. So Ka'ba is the support, spiritual support, and social support, community support. It is the center that brings the community together. And money is of course the financial support, and both these supports are needed. So money is a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but money also could be a trouble. And it's important to see that Quran warns about that money could be a big trouble. That if your children, your body, and your money is a business, it's a trial. And so it is important that the bad aspect should be avoided. And the good aspect should be increased. The good aspect should be increased is that by, first of all, money should not make you forget Allah. Very often the Quran mentioned that people forget their Lord and their Creator. Once they have a few dollars in their pocket, they think that they are independent. Nay, it is the surah that was revealed first to Prophet. In that surah, Allah says, "Billah, inna al-insan la yatgha." Nay, human being transgress. He thinks himself rich. The moment he thinks himself rich, he becomes I don't need anything. Allah says, "Inna ila rabbika ruj'a."
remember the God in your return.
So be careful, always remember God in every situation. Remember God, don't forget, then earn in the halal way, in the right way. Earning, investment, whatever you do it in the right way. And do not cheat, do not steal, do not deceive, do not do all kind of the wrong thing in making the money. Because that is the money is good, but it should be earned in the right way. So they become halal and tayyib, good and lawful. And also it should be spent in the right way. Don't waste, not the simple. Do not waste your money. And the other thing is that remember the rights of those who do not have. There are people who have and people who do not have. So give them their right. So Muslim community in America, mashallah, is a large community. We have about 8 million, 10 million Muslims, and the number is increasing. And this community is a unique community where we have people from all over. Almost every ethnic group of Muslims is represented among the Muslims of Allah Ta'ala. And a high number of professionals, great business people, great talent, great minds are there, alhamdulillah. These people should really think how we can use all this talent that we have so that we can benefit ourselves from the resources that we have in this beautiful, rich country with great facility and resources that are there, and then also benefit the humanity. Halal is not only for Muslims. Halal is a benefit that you are halal. It's for the benefit of every Muslim. And I like that that so long as they have this, sometimes this kosher is not only for the produce, they say everybody can enjoy it. Opening that kosher mail on the island, so that you can enjoy it. The point is that halal is for everyone. Everyone can benefit. That is for everyone. And we have to make this point to the people that halal is good for the whole world, for every American, for every human being. And that is what it is. This is the message for everyone. It's not for any particular group of people, for everyone. And for this, we support this kind of activity. That is done here at the American Kindness House. You know, the Islamic study of North America will be holding a major conference here, inshallah, in July. So I hope Dr. Yaqub not mind making some commercial. Some of you might have seen this beautiful trial here. And this is about the Islamic banking and finance conference that will be holding. Part of Islamic mission to make the community understand how to earn in the right way. How to become rich in the right way. So for this reason, we have been holding these conferences, and this time this conference will be here in California from the 14th to 16th of July in Long Beach. And at the same time, we have another conference, which is on Islam and the Internet. And both of them are quite related. A lot of people make money from this, from the Internet. So, here at the same time, in the same place, both conferences. I hope you will keep those dates in the calendar. And let us see you all, inshallah. God bless you. Assalamu alaikum.